Okay, people, so this is a demo and review of the Bubble Grub Bubble Room from Lush, and it's available for spring. So I'm not exactly sure the date they're gonna stop selling it, but as long as it's springtime, this will be here. So it looks like a little bug. I already used all of it, so I can't show you, but I will link. I would add a picture and the demo at the end of this video. But basically, when I first smelled it, I was like, ew, I didn't like the scent at all. To me, it smelled like peanuts. It smelled like really like herbally, and I was not a fan of the smell. And the reason I bought it was because I was ordering online, and I just typed in Tonka, the ingredient, Tonka, which if you guys know me, I love. And Tonka has a scent of like burnt sugar, kind of vanilla-y. So I just put anything with Tonka in my shopping cart. So I had never smelled this before. So when I got it, I smelled it, thought it was nasty. And I had bought two because I thought I was gonna like it, because I thought it was gonna have like a strong Tonka scent. But it didn't. But I was like, you know what? Let me just like try it at least and see if the scent changes in the bath, because sometimes the scent does change a little bit once you use it. And also, it was a bubble room, so it had a lot of like moisturizing like ingredients in it. So I thought, let me just try it. People, this is why you should not automatically dismiss something that you think smells gross. Because I put it in my bath and I loved it. I love the smell. What changed about the smell was that each time I used half of it, so it's like a bubble room, so it has two parts. So each time I used one half. So I think the fact that it was not as like condensed helped. The fact that it like, you know, spread out and mixed in with my warm water helped the scent not be as like, you know, heavy or whatever. And the scent ended up smelling like, you guys ever smelled anything that's like scented like milk and honey, like lotions or like soaps or anything that's scented like milk and honey? That's what it smelled like. And I was like, oh my god. I will say that the bubbles weren't like, you know, didn't really last too long, as you guys will see in the clip, I think. I made like a decent amount of bubbles to begin with, but like after you sit in it for like, you know, half an hour or whatever, the bubbles kind of dissolve, which is like, whatever. I just really love the smell, and the water was not so like moisturizing as other things I have tried from Lush, but it was pretty decent. What I will say is, the face part of the bubble grub, his eyes are actually like bath melts. So the head part of it is gonna be more moisturizing than the butt part. It does have a little bit of shimmer on it, but honestly, it's not too much. Like when I was in the bath, I was trying to look for the shimmer in the water. The shimmer didn't really, it's just very minimal amount of shimmer. And then what else can I say? Oh, and the scent of it lingers. People, I took a bath with this yesterday afternoon, 24 hours later. I can still smell it, and I really love the smell. So, yes, I definitely recommend at least trying it. You know, some people might love the scent just from picking it up and smelling it. Some people might love it. But if you don't love it, I don't know, I would say try it. And I, you know, ended up really liking this little guy. And let me just read you some of the ingredients that are in here. Organic shea butter, vetiver oil, tonka absolute, sandalwood oil, gardenia extract, fair trade vanilla pod. Oh, the antennas are vanilla pods. They're not tonka like I thought, because I actually broke it in the tub. I broke the pod in half. It was vanilla. White chocolate, cocoa butter, dry whole milk, natural vanilla, dairy-free, chocolate drops, and yes. Let me just read you what it says. This adorable little critter is here to transform your tub into a silky, softening, and bubbly haven. Crumble him up under your running tap, then dive under a blanket of sweet vanilla, tonka, and sandalwood foam. It's creamy organic shea butter filling leaves, skin velvety soft, and his fair trade vanilla pod antennae steep in the bathwater for a truly rich and indulgent soak. It says, yeah, his eyes are made of two types of chocolate for a creamy bath. Only here for spring. Oh, and it says literary inspiration. Bubble Grub was inspired by the children's story, The Very Hungry Caterpillar. Oh my god, I love that story! I love The Very Hungry Caterpillar. You know what they should have done, though? Is made him longer. So, like, made, like, him double the size. Because The Very Hungry Caterpillar is not, like, tiny. The Very Hungry Caterpillar is, like, fat because he ate a lot of food. That's why he's very hungry. So that would have been cool. Maybe next time they should make him bigger. And they get four baths out of it. That'd be awesome. Anyways, that is all I have to say. Oh, and let me just tell you real quick. It was $7.95. I mean, I think that the bubble runes are like a better value because you can definitely use them twice and they're easy to break apart. So it's like two for one. Anyways, that is what I have to say about the Bubble Grab Bubble Rune. Love him. He is so cute. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace. Definitely a ton more bubbles, but that's the color of the head of the bubble grub. It's just orange. And yes.